Hey you guys and girls, and thank you for watching to another episode of the Xbox Tester. My name is Maurice, and today we are going to try Crysis Remastered for the second time. It just got a major big update, and I really want to get into this. I already did a video a few months ago, I think 2 or 3 months ago on this game, and it wasn't optimized right then, so it only was the Xbox One version, but they now finally have updated it for next gen. So it's pretty amazing what they have done. So first of all, let's check how much data the game is on your hard drive, and that's 16.4 gigabytes, so it's a little bit bigger than last time. Let's see how much the game is in the store. Oh, it's only $18 right now, so you can get it right now with a discount. I don't know when you are watching this video, so if you are watching this video in the future, sorry if it's not that price anymore. Let's head into it. So the biggest news about this game, and I think that's pretty amazing what they have done, the game runs native 4K on 30 FPS on Xbox Series S. That's pretty insane. There are only a handful of games that are running a native 4K on Xbox Series S. Sadly, not 60 FPS, but it has three modes. And I'm only going to test one of those modes because I don't like 30 FPS. P.S. If you like this kind of content, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. It means a lot for me, it means a lot to the channel. We're on the road to 10k subscribers, so it would mean a lot to me if you could help me with that. And let's see, press the menu button to begin. First of all, I'm going to show you the video settings. So, it has a quality mode. Quality mode is native 4K, so 2160p, 30 FPS. You've got ray tracing mode, that's 1080p, also 30 FPS. My go-to will be performance mode. So that's 1080p on 60 FPS. And that's the mode you should play. If you really want that high frame of a high high pixel count, yeah, go for quality. Are you completely into ray tracing? You can pick ray tracing. I don't give that much about those two, so I'm going for performance mode. No motion blur, because I really hate motion blur. I'm allergic to motion blur. Let's do this level. So yeah, this game is, what, I think 15, 16 years old right now, as I'm making this video, and it still holds up. It's insane what they did back then with this game, but look at this. Beautiful 60 FPS, you guys. I love it. That's how all games should do on Xbox Series S. 1080p, 60 FPS. That's what I want to see in all games. I don't give that much about ray tracing or all those other stuff. Yeah, it looks nice, but does it really add to the gameplay? Nah, I don't think so. Frame rate is much, much, much better. Look at this. Man, this looks good.
All right, listen up.
So the draw distance could be a little bit better. I've noticed it on some other system that it looked a little bit better. Ooh, chickens.
Understood.
Here, chicken, 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 chicken. I already knew the batteries were almost done. So let's do some driving. Oh yeah, that's how it worked. I always need to check how the shooting and stuff works in this game. So it's a little bit like Far Cry. I think Far Cry was even based on these games. I really hoped they would do a remake of Crysis 2. Because to be honest, I think that's my favorite Crysis game. I think that one was even better than this one. But yeah, can it run Crysis? Yes, it can run Crysis pretty good. Finally. Oh, come on. My car is completely done. Look at how smooth this game runs right now. I love it. Yeah, you should definitely check it out. And for $17, it's also a cool benchmark game for Series S and X. Oh, darn it. I wasn't paying attention.
You guys aren't gonna believe this. Oh. It sounds like General Ri Chan-kyong is in charge of the whole operation. The guy behind that massacre a few years back, well, why would he be here? I don't know.
But wow, this looks good.
These guys are hardcore. You're approaching a KPA radar station. Find a terminal and access their tactical network.
So much better than expected. Bye bye. Let's do some cardio. Killed a lot of those people. But yeah, I can bring quality mode up. I don't think it will be that big a difference. But let's see. This is a nice point to put on quality mode. If there's a big difference, I don't think there's a big difference. So yeah, this is the game running on quality mode, but you can, it dips so hard in the frame rate. But yeah, native 4K, that's pretty hardcore for such a little console. Even on Xbox Series X, it runs at it can run on Series X at a quality mode on 2160 60 FPS. Performance mode is 1080p 60 FPS. I don't know why. That's a little bit stupid. And ray tracing runs at a 1440p 60 FPS on Series X. So think it's really mind-boggling what they did with this version, to be honest. Oh, what am I doing? And I had the discussion last week also with someone. I think you need to see the Xbox Series S as the perfect 1080p 60fps machine. And if it can handle ray tracing, yeah, put in ray tracing. But only if it runs at 60fps. And the only game I've seen so far was Observer System Redux that could handle both. So 1080p, 60fps and ray tracing on. I don't even care that much about 1440p because I'm now playing on a 1440p monitor. And it's a monitor that has 144Hz. It's a Samsung G5, so... But yeah, this looks incredible. This is what I wanted to see. On a next-gen game. Smooth, nice gameplay. So I'm probably going to die. Yeah, there's my shotgun. Boom! Boom! So, I went out with a bang. You guys, I really want to thank you for watching to this episode of the Xbox Tester. If you want to see any games running on Xbox Series S or X, please let me know. And I will see you guys in the next episode. So, till then, bye-bye.